Hello everyone and welcome to the Wolf's Side channel! Today we have a very special topic, I mean always special, the real money trading problem. And what I mean by that is that people buying often gold from cheaters or people who were hacking the game or stuff like that, and that is hurting everyone. That is hurting the in-game economy, that is hurting every player, that is hurting Star Vault. This is bad. I mean, Star Vault is really doing stuff against the real money traders, that they are banning accounts each month. And Henrik also stated that they have better tools to track them down, to hunt them down and to ban them. People who sell gold to others for real money and people who are buying the gold. 86 accounts alone in April, and this is nearly each month they're banning about 100 accounts, sometimes 50. But you ban all these accounts and then they are plopping up everywhere again. I mean, there are also offers to buy in-game materials. And of course, Star Vault is tracking every trade and they really want to get rid of all the real money traders. The problem is this real money trade shit exists nearly in every game where you can trade. If you, for example, look at Tarkov, Tarkov had some real problems with the real money traders, and it still has problems with the real money traders because people still trading stuff in game. Then they increased the flea market prices, then they removed the found in raid status, then they did that, then they did that, then they all the measures Tarkov took over the last 8 years got only a little bit of result. Because the problem with real money trading is because it's very, very hard to track down. Because if my friend gave me just a half a stack of gold because I gave him a half a stack of gold a few years ago, that is the problem. So you can't ban everyone who's just giving money to someone else. And that is exactly the problem. While real money trading is very hard to track down. I mean, Star Vault really trying their best to do that. But what I've read from a few posts of people who are doing the real money trading shit and stuff like that is they're using other IP addresses. They're doing hardware spoofing. They never use their real accounts, and sometimes they don't even have real accounts. They are just people from India, people from China, people from Nigeria, people from Argentina who just want to make money to live. There are real money traders out there who don't even play the game, who don't even know the mechanics of the game. They are buying themselves a hack. Often it's very small companies. Sometimes it's individuals who are buying big hacks. Having even developers for developing hacks for that game. Making hacking money, cheating money, and then trading it. And yeah, real money trading is a problem in nearly every game. I mean, if you live, I don't know, somewhere, you are getting only $100 a month in normal salary, or you could sell, for example, I don't know, stacks of gold in Mortal, and you're making three times the money. And that is exactly the problem. And we can only hope that Star Vault is really, really, really increasing their effort to stop that. And as I have said, from all the bugs you encounter a bug as a player, and it sometimes don't even reaches the devs. And yet, it's an iceberg of problems. I mean, I don't know where you work, but in the most companies, this is exactly the problem. And these numbers are made up from myself. I don't know. I really don't know. I even guess Henrik has maybe knows more problems. Because the communications between all these layers is not so great as you maybe think. And that is why Star Vault sometimes don't even get the bug you reported. But that doesn't matter anyway. This is just a hypothetical chart of mine, so don't take it seriously, you know? But a lot of players saying that real money trading is a huge problem. And the thing is that not every problem gets the importance it's maybe needed, because not all players are talking about that stuff. So it's important to talk about that problem, because it's not the first game where this is a huge problem. And I only know one game where real money trading is not possible. And that is Black Desert. No shit. You can't even trade with other people. And you can only trade potions and stuff like that. But the problem is, it has a huge item shop. No one wants that shit. You can throw your money out of the window in that game, to get yourself benefits and stuff like that from their in-game shop. But yeah, they have literally no real money trading. But even then, people hire other people to play and grind the game for them. No shit. And yeah, there are also services for that for Immortal Online. And I'm thinking to myself, what the fuck? Why would you not play a game and pay someone else to play the game? It's so out of my mind. I can't even imagine that. And real money trading is shit because it gives an unfair advantage to someone else just that he has real life money. And this is the thing of online gaming, that people are in games nearly always equal. Because their financial real-life state has nothing to do with the in-game shit. And that is why I hate item and in-game shops like hell. And this is why the subscription system of Mortal Online is great, but this is another topic. But people in games are equal, and if you can buy for millions of dollars an in-game benefit, then it's not fair anymore. And this is why so many players are so angry about the real money trading. And I'm also very angry. I could really rant whole fucking day about that. Because we, as a Wolfside guild, farming all our shit, and we have to defend our territory and our shit against maybe... I will not say that someone else did that, but we have to defend our shit maybe against someone who is just paying real life money to get gold to buy more catapults to annoy us. And we have to grind all that shit to defend ourselves or to attack. Maybe, Henrik, maybe you can understand why a lot of players are very hardcore pissed about that. But yeah, I know development is hard. And I'm really glad that Star World already confirmed that they are looking further to improve the real money trading tracking and will ban more people. And hopefully they will get all this under control. And this would be awesome. But this is also an illusion. I can prop this illusion directly in your head. There's no game out there who has a real protection against real money trading. The only game I personally know is Black Desert, because it's so restricted that you can't trade, but people are also selling their services to grind for you. The only real measurement that helps against real money trading is playing offline. There you have it. My only hope is that, I don't know, there will be some AI in the future, in maybe a few years or something like that, that can really predict or really, really hardcore investigate all the game logs, all the stuff a player does, and then can automatically come to the conclusion that this is a real money trader and ban him. Because otherwise you would need a lot of staff to do that, and I guess Star Wars don't have that.
By the way, staff magic. Next magic school. Okay, yeah, okay.
And no, I didn't set any guild in this whole video. And I'm not accusing anyone of real money trading. Just to make that clear. But please let me know what you think about all this in the comments. And please also leave a like and subscribe and share this video with your friends. And special thanks to all the supporters, of course. Carmel, Professor Oloke, Ronus, Patalax, Krum, Bullock, Giovanni Vargas, Remap for Swipgrid, Cyrus, Mipgrid, Hayu, and all the others, of course. So never forget to ban hard. Party hard. Never forget to make party hard. And see you all next time. Goodbye.